I hope everybody is doing well. My today's topic is adjective, which is a part of the basic grammar. And I'll be introducing adjective to you in this video. What is an adjective? A word which is used to describe a noun or pronoun in a sentence is called adjective. And how to learn adjectives, how to practice, you know, learning adjective. On a piece of paper, right in the middle of the paper, write the name of a person, a place, or a thing. And then think about that place, what kind of place that is. Or think about that person, what kind of person that is. For example, you write the noun New York. And think about it, you know, what kind of city that is. So any word that describes that place, New York, is an adjective. For example, you say New York is a big city, so big is an adjective. New York is a beautiful city, so beautiful is an adjective. New York is a crowded city, so the word crowded is an adjective. Or for example, New York is a populated city, so populated is a past participle adjective. So that is the best way. This way you can increase your vocabulary. And even if, you know, you write those adjectives, I mean those words which can describe, I mean that noun, in your own language, if you don't know, I mean, you know what, I mean, the word is in your own language, what the adjective is in your own language, but you don't know what it is in English. So that's even okay, because you just write a lot, as many words as possible, the words that can describe that place or that person or that thing. And then later on, go and look it up in a dictionary. Look, I mean, find the meaning of those, I mean the adjectives, those words that you wrote in your own language, then just write, you know, find them in a dictionary. And this way you can increase your vocabulary and you can learn adjectives. For example, you write the name of a person, okay, let's say Donald Trump, for example, okay, Donald Trump. So what kind of person? Donald Trump is a strong person. Strong is an adjective. Donald Trump is a wealthy person, right? Wealthy is an adjective. So any word that describes, you know, that noun is an adjective. Adjective has different types. Adjectives of quantity and quality, and adjectives of conditions, and adjectives of, you know, origin. But I'll be making a separate video to explain, describe, you know, the types of adjective and their usages and sentences. This video is just about the introduction of adjective, and you know how we use adjectives and sentences. And you know they have three forms. In these sentences, I've brought each of those three forms. Like we have simple adjectives, we have past participle adjectives, we have present participle adjectives. In the degrees, you know, a simple degree and or positive degree and comparative degree and superlative degree. So I'm not explaining, I mean, these degrees in details, but I'm just telling you that these are the forms of adjectives and the, you know, the degrees of adjectives. So now look at these examples. In the first example, Japan is a historical country. So here the word historical is an adjective. Why? Because it describes the noun country or the noun, I mean, Japan. And of course, it answers the question, what kind of country is Japan? So it is a historical country. Look at the second example. He is a dedicated person. He is a dedicated person. So now here the word dedicated is adjective. And that was just like a simple adjective, simple form, the adjective. But dedicated, it's the past participle form of adjective. The third form of a verb can function as an adjective if it describes a noun or pronoun. So it describes the noun person. So what kind of person is he? He is a dedicated person. I bought an interesting book yesterday. So here, interesting is a present participle adjective. Dedicated is past participle adjective, and interesting, present participle adjective. It describes the noun book. What kind of book did I buy yesterday? I bought a an interesting book. And example number four, my brother is taller than me. My brother is taller than me. Here, the word taller is an adjective. Why? Because it describes the noun my brother, okay? So, but this adjective is in comparative degree, tall, just positive or simple degree, and taller, comparative degree. And he is one of the best singers in the world. So here, the word best functions as an adjective. It is an adjective. Why? Because it describes, you know, the noun singers. So it's an adjective. But in the superlative degree. Okay? So, like good, positive degree, better, comparative degree, best, or the best is the superlative degree. So now, in these examples, you learned that we have the three forms of adjectives, you know, positive forms or simple forms, and past participle form, and present participle form, and comparative form, and superlative form, or in superlative degree or in comparative degree. So I hope that you will follow my advice, and whenever you are trying to practice to learn a lot of adjectives and to improve your vocabulary as well, so just write the name of a person, a place, or a thing, or an organization, for example, okay? The name of a religion, for example, the name of anything. You just write, a noun or pronoun. And then think about the words which can describe or modify, which can give you some sort of information about that place, person, or thing. And all of those words will be adjectives. They could be in different forms, but they're adjectives. This way you can learn a lot of adjectives. Have a great time, and bye-bye.